Hello, beautiful strangers, and welcome back to another episode of Myth. When last we left off, it's been a stressful couple of days. Things are okay now, hopefully. Things are okay now, unless something different happens would be stressful. But yeah, things are good now. More or less, anyway. We got to see a scene and learned a little bit about Yuri, the Lowenthal. Do we know her last name? Yamagami, I'm pretty sure. And her case against Oz. And, interestingly enough, I actually quite like those scenes, so, I'm looking forward to them. They're decently long, most of them are, but they're fun, I like them. But anyway, let's get back into it, shall we? Total darkness. A darkness so deep that I couldn't even make out my surroundings. Shimon finally spoke up. Over here. I felt something warm in the palm of my hand. It seemed like she was holding it. I began to walk, that warmth serving as my guide. It's so dark. I can't see a thing. It was as though there was no sunlight at all in this world. I couldn't make out any visible light source. Ah, I forgot. Shimon told me to stay still, so I did just that. Huh. Then she proceeded to hit me on the head. That hurt. Sorry, that should make things better. She told me to look carefully. I focused on my surroundings and the darkness began to clear away, revealing a cave of sorts. Where are we? In a passageway between the world of light and the world of shadows. Huh. She began to walk again, and I followed behind her. How did you do that? Was that Shimon magic? You said it before I got to. She swung her arms about, trying to make it seem like it was all mysterious. Oh. You don't seem to believe me. Of course not. Why would we need any lighting at all if you could just make things bright by hitting someone? Light's pretty useful for waking you up, but I have to admit that I look pretty pathetic when I do. But wait, there's more. Like the Shimon punch. I can send people flying over 50 meters with it. Apologize to Newton right now. Don't you like my buff and sexy body? Her arms look like sticks. I sighed as I gazed at her flexing. Her biceps were tiny. Let's just pretend it's magic. There was no point in arguing. Ah, I can see the sunlight. I squinted. Before me were sprawling grasslands. It felt like the world was flooded with light, perhaps because I was been in the dark for so long. That seems... Oh well. Welcome to the world of shadows. It was nothing like my world, but it felt somehow nostalgic just being here. What's wrong?
Oh, out of curiosity.
Oh, would you look at that? Our notebook is fine. She gawked at me. Nothing. It was kind of annoying when people picked up on my feelings like that. I decided to just respond in a vague manner. Over here. Shimon started to walk again. The grass bust against my legs with every step. It was pleasant to feel that soft sensation on my skin. We reached what had initially served as the horizon. A number of buildings were visible beyond there. What are those? What do you think? buildings.
Hi, pretty girl. Cat, cat, cat.
Katze. You've earned a point. Not you. You've not earned a point. Cat.
I looked at her face. She looked back at me with a smile. And who owns those buildings? Who do you think? Shadows. You've earned a second point.
Not you. Not you.
We'll play after, I finish recording, okay?
You're making fun of me. Never mind. I probably shouldn't follow up on that. Or at least, that's what my instinct was telling me. You probably didn't even realize that wasn't what I meant. Let's go. She began to walk forward. Wait. What's wrong? This is overgrowth, right? I'm having a hard time walking through it.
What are you doing? Why are you trying to get at my Gatorade bottle?
Oh, there's a trick to that. It'd be nice if you could teach me. I'm feeling all constrained here. The trick is to walk with long strides. Super strides. It's simple. Just take wide steps. Doing so means your feet reach the ground less, which prevents the overgrowth from getting in the way. It's based on the scientific science. I'm such a genius. The super strides thing is because this is the sequel. It honestly wasn't worth it to argue with her, so I just did what she said.
Hey, behave. We'll play after I finish recording. I told you this.
You know this. This is a schedule for you at this point.
You dropped something. Oh. I didn't realize that I dropped my notebook in the grass until Shimon pointed it out. What's that? My notebook. I'm not going to bother to explain. But communication. We need to communicate. Okay, how about this? According to the instruction books, this is something of a necessity for forgetful people like you. It's a cool instruction book. Hey, there was a missing name on that. That's just how it is. Don't take it seriously. Anyway, there's something I want to ask you. Let's find a place where we can chill out so I can ask. Okay. We finished walking through the trail and reached a gathering spot of sorts. Looks like a village. The residents of that village were basically what you'd expect, or what you expected, shadows. They're people with pitch black bodies, so really, that's all they could be called. You've got some good naming sense. You're not praising me, are you? Not that I know who came up with the name. I gazed at the shadow people once again. I had heard of them before, but I'd never seen them. I was worried they'd be creepy, but I was actually totally okay with them. Not that it wasn't a strange scene. I couldn't stop thinking, though, despite the fact that Shimon was trying to whistle and failing miserably. I can whistle. I'm not going to whistle into the microphone, though. The shadows gazed at me as we passed by them. It was to be expected, though. I was an oddity here, after all. I don't remember who was in the oddities. The only one I remember by name is Bertha Fay. I don't remember who else was in the oddities, actually. ICP, maybe? I don't remember. There were never somebody I paid attention to, and the only reason I know Bertha Fay was part of it was because, of her career in Japan. Anyway. Wow, you're Mr. Popular. Shimon joked about that. I don't remember what her name was. Something Sing something? I don't remember. You're pretty much the same as me, though. I realized there was an inconsistency with the situation. No one's actually looking at you. Because I've lived here for years. So they're used to you? That's right. Really? No, I guess it made sense. If shadows were in my world, it'd be a huge deal. Were the people here just accepting or careless? I didn't know, but there was a huge cultural gap between this world and mine. Their buildings were rather old-fashioned. It made me think that their technological advancement wasn't anywhere near as developed as that of mine. It truly is a different world.
What are you doing?
I had only seen this type of scenery in textbooks before, and I really did believe what I just said. This way. Shimon walked with a skip in her step as we headed towards the village. Shimon! I heard a commotion from behind us as we walked through the village. What's going on? Where did you go? I was so worried. Are you okay? You're not hurt, right? Who's that? The shadow just trampled me. She stood there on top of me. Yuri-chan, this is... Yes, you can't come back because this guy was chasing you, right? I'm definitely right. She was completely off. No, that's not it. This is... Anyway, don't strike back at guys like this. Just keep up with their pace as you make your escape. Got it? Is that so? And that wasn't right at all. Mr. Stalker, please calm down. Let's hear your story. Calm down first, then we can talk. I'm always cool. I'm ice cold. That's funny, coming from someone showing me their panties. Even though it was just silhouette, I could see the inside of her skirt. She finally got off of me. I'm ice cold. Just what you'd expect from one of Shimon's friends. She was a total weirdo. Her silhouette also looks familiar, but, you know. Who are you? Shimon's friend? And she has a familiar name. Shimon? You don't deserve to call her by that name. She's a She wasn't even being coherent. I'm asking you if you're friends. Something like that. We're not lovers, just... besties, basically. Shimon cut her off. Besties with Shimon. So happy. Well, I can tell you're kind of noisy at the very least. She's been like this for ages. Ouch, tongue. Ow. Shimon said her name was Yuri and that they were best friends. So what are you? Someone with a body and a shadow like Shimon here? No. Look. I pointed at my back. There was no shadow, of course. That was a definitive difference between Shimon and me. Oh, I see. You're from that place. Yeah, that place. It was like I was some kind of illegal immigrant or something. Totanabe-san, he's a student. A student? Why? Why? It's obligatory. You don't need to go to school to live. No, we have no choice. Yuri glared at me, suspicious. I don't follow. Your brain's kind of on low performance, and huh? Performance better than yours. Wait, what's that supposed to mean? Tell me your specs. I'll give you a fair evaluation. Yuri groaned. She was...
You know you can jump into that box without issues, right? Yeah, there you go.
Silly cat. Yuri groaned. She was so dumb. We'll be leaving now. Shimon was clearly troubled as she tried to get us to hurry along. No, let's talk a little more. Nope, we really gotta split. Don't want to make Granny mad, you know? Were they really best friends? Either way, I was happy if we could get out of here. I'm not used to people like that. I was beginning to get tired just talking with her. Hurry? Where? Back to my place. Meto-san has nowhere to stay, so I was gonna let him sleep at my house. I had a bad feeling about what she just said. What? You can't do that. Who knows what he'll do to you? I knew it.
Are you enjoying the box now, huh?
You can't just spend the night outdoors. Well, that's perfect. Spend the night outdoors. Boys get stronger when they're pushed off cliffs, after all. No, you'd be weaker. Or rather, you'd be dead. Shut up, yawn looker. I'm totally being the one being discussed here. Whatever. If Shimon would let me stay at her place, that'd be perfect. But if someone's that thoroughly against it, then I wasn't going to force her to let me stay over. Ah, jeez, fine. We'll have to spend the night together at Shimon's. Yuri seemed ecstatic. Man, I guess there's nothing I can do if I gotta protect Shimon. It's the only natural thing for me to do as her friend. Your ulterior motives are showing. I don't want to hear that from you. You tried to Shimon, am I right? It needs to be less obvious. Anyway, let's get going. Shimon's house is only 3 steps west and 5 steps north. That's where the grocer is, though. What do you know that? Do you ever... Oh, well, I guess it was... Okay, yeah, that would be close. Never mind, he could see it. Do you ever shut up? Just go with the flow, it's really beyond that hill. Okay, let's do this. Race to the top. Yuri sped off after that.
What are you doing? You're in a more playful mood than usual, huh?
Shimon and I just leisurely walked, though.
Now. Are you in a mood? Is that what it is? Are you in a mood?
As we reached the top of the hill, I caught sight of Yuri lying on the ground beside the gate. Yuri, you're so fast. Shimon gave her a thumbs up. That's the power of love. What a sad friendship. Let's go inside then. We stepped inside with Shimon in the lead. It's normal. It was a bit old-fashioned, though. There was a nice contrast between the wooden buildings and tatami mats, and the pond and the garden made for a beautiful view. Wooden buildings, tatami mats, a pond. It was like I entered the world of my textbooks or something. So tired. Yuri leaned against the table. Its historical value seemed to instantly drop upon seeing her do that. I never thought I'd see a real wooden building like this. It felt like I had traveled to the past. I wasn't particularly impressed, though, for some reason. I brought my nose towards the tatami mat and began to sniff it. What are you doing?
You too. What are you doing? What are you doing?
I've never seen a tatami mat before. I get it. It's all new to you. Okay, then don't hold back. Go ahead and sniff all you like. Weirdo. I stopped acting like a perverted weirdo after that. Shimon stood up too. Have a seat. Then she disappeared into the back of the house. Could I have some barley tea, please? Fine. I got comfy. We're pretty friendly with Shimon. That's just how we are. Right, Shimon? Yuri made sexy eyes at the door Shimon just left through. I'm a strong girl. She had completely changed in an instant. Are you really Shimon's friend? I was bored, so I decided to ask her that. That's not nice. We're best of buds. Even Shimon said that. No, it just seems like she's playing along. There's nothing for some outsider like you to worry about. I've been looking after her since she was a kid. A kid? How old are you? It wouldn't surprise me if she was in her teens or her 40s, given the way she looked. Ah, that might be a fun way to kill some time. Let's try a quiz then.
Hey, stop that.
This was getting strange. 24? Wonderful, you win 100 pesos. Was I right? No, I'm 40. It's not close to 24 at all. Get a cute... Why? 40 though? Really? You've got stuff you need to do. You should really take note of that. Give me some vitality and money, senor. She really was evil. Hurry for the wait. Shimon soon appeared with a tray. Here's some tea. There was rice, cookies, and tea on the tray. My tea was hot while Yuri's was cold. Thanks. So I guess they treated each other like friends. Not that it really mattered to me. This is the stuff. She gulped it down like some old geezer. Do old people just gulp down whatever, I don't care. Go ahead, Mito-san. You don't want any? No, I'm scared. What? Why? I was starting to get used to this culture, but I was still a bit reluctant to try their food and such. I decided to hold back for the time being. Anyway, I changed the subject. There's something I want to ask you. Okay, hit me. I looked at Shimon once again. I should probably ask her what I wanted to. So, about that shadow, why do you have one? This? I was born with it. Are there any other people that have both shadow and a body? No. She sipped on her tea. Really? Oui. Take it easy. I made to stand up when... Leave it to me. Well, nope. Shimon suddenly grabbed my leg. I want to know about that voice I heard. Also, I was interested in you. But by that, I meant that I wanted to help her. I wanted help from someone who wasn't her, though. There's no point in me hanging around if you don't know anyone else who has both a body and a shadow.
Wait, I'm capable, you know?
I do know that you're lying. Searching around for that voice with her serving as my guide wouldn't get me anywhere.
So cruel. I'm gonna sue.
I'll be waiting for you with ink and pen.
See ya.
I headed for the entrance as she lamented. Then I remembered something. Oh, right.
Please wait. If you want, I'll...
You'll what?
I wanted to ask her about that. I guess I should do so before I leave. I was surprised when you first told me your name. Look at this. I took out my notebook from my backpack. That list of strange names. Maybe she'd know something about it.
What about it?
Not that. This. I turned the page and pointed at the part where Shimon was written. It's probably a coincidence. Did you look at all of this? No, I just had a cursory glance. She placed the notebook on the table and she rested her elbow upon it. Anything come to mind? It seemed like she'd realized something.
No? Wait, yes. I know all about it, so please stay here a bit.
Bye now. Her being so predictable made things easy for me. I reached out for the notebook, and she grabbed my wrist.
At least have some tea.
I said I don't want any.
It's amazing.
You're persistent.
Fine, I'll give in.
She placed the teacup back on the tray. She let out painfully fake sobs. I did feel a little bad, but whatever. I took the notebook and...
Yeah.
The table shook.
Uh-huh.
Sending tea flying all over the place. What are you doing?
My mistake.
It spread all across the table. My notebook wasn't there.
Oh, nice job.
Yuri seemed to have reacted quickly, grabbing the notebook before it got all wet with tea. She proceeded to look through it. Got any ideas?
No, I don't know any of this.
Man, don't get my hopes up. That was strange. Yuri was surprisingly more calm than usual.
Here.
Oh, thanks. She handed me the notebook. Give that a good look over. There's some interesting stuff written in there. Interesting stuff? I began to look through it from the beginning. Concerning this notebook, day 20 update. To the next me, if you're viewing this notebook in the possession of your own will, read the rest from start to finish. What I write here may be unbelievable to you now, but it's all true. Huh? It was like the text was directly speaking to me, like a journal or some first-person novel. It was neither of those things, though. It was my notebook from school. Did someone swipe it and write it in at some point? If so, why would someone write this kind of stuff? This was what the author was stating. 1. The world I live in is fiction. On the 10th day in this world, people will begin to explode or disappear. 2. This world of fiction is known as myth. There are people who run this world and those that are run by those people in this world. 3. Einherjar are people who have died in the real world. Everyone besides me is already dead. I, too, am probably dead. Four. If Ragnarok occurs, then the Einherjar will be returned to this world, or to the world.
Shit, dropped my phone. Where'd it go?
Five. I was a student living in a place called Tokyo in the year 2002. I was locked in myth, my so-called world of fiction, by my parents. It was comical how fantasy-like the story was. It was even too absurd for it to be science fiction. If this were some third-rate broke author's novel or something, then that'd be fine. I could just laugh it off as some garbage devoid of any realism. But the truth was, this was written in my own notebook.
Here.
Yuri pointed at a certain passage from the notebook. If this seems impossible to believe, then try to remember your friends or parents. This? I tried to shrug it off just to get her to stop. There was no reason for me to do that, though, because this had nothing to do with me. Are you really telling me to apply that to myself? No one actually said what was written in there. I felt silly for even repeating it.
Yes?
Come on. I was surprisingly flustered. Not reality. Fictional world? Myth? Are you stupid? Why was I... Are you saying I'm not real? That I'm just fiction too? I mean, my life was boring. I just lived alone even though I was a student that did the same things every day. So, but don't say that none of that was real. Defensive. My parents are... My parents are... Was I going to accept it after all? No way. It was just a coincidence that I couldn't remember. I couldn't even remember who gave birth to me. Mato. And this is a joke, Right. You remember a girl by the name of Yuri Yamagami? Huh? I'm asking you if you remember. I don't know her. Yuri pointed at a line a page over. It was about my lover. Yuri Yamagami. I can't remember much about her, but she had a rather lax personality in my world. She was always late when we were supposed to meet up. It wasn't even annoying, just sad. Her looks were average. She was short. But given that always late came to mind, it meant that we've been dating or known each other for a long time. I don't know. I'm telling you. I don't know. That's a weird thing to say to me after meeting me for the first time in ages. You're Yuri Yamagami? That's impossible. I understand that this isn't easy. However, I don't think it's better to not know the truth. Shut up. I was doing exactly what you wanted.
You're just in a mood, aren't you? Yes, we'll play after I finish recording.
All I could do was pant. Everything else besides that panting, however, was silent. It was like time itself had frozen. Oh my, oh dear. Shimon broke the silence, singing some strange tune. Who are you? Ah, my throat's being weird. You don't know? I only know that you're our enemy. This isn't the first time we've met. Well, I guess you can understand if you don't remember. I couldn't get a read on Shimon. I'm mistaken. I would remember if we met before. You're not wrong. Anyway, that's enough of that complicated stuff. Yuri Yamagami-san, welcome to the world of shadows. World of shadows? You mean this isn't your little dollhouse? How's it feel being here? Horrible. Yuri sat down on the tatami mats as she sneered at Shimon. I see, you haven't figured out how wonderful myth is just yet. That's right. Why not? Why not? Perfect things don't suit me. They make me anxious. This is too beautiful of a place for someone to live. Shimon laughed so loudly she snorted. You're such a poor girl, a hopeless ill girl, a fool, rubbish. Shimon opened the sliding door. Beyond that door was darkness. I couldn't see a thing.
Hey, you behave. Be nice. Be nice.
Where are you going? I'm leaving. You did something you shouldn't have. Wait a second. Shimon. What? She peered down at me like I was some inferior life form. I couldn't even see a glint in her eyes.
What are you in a mood for? What are you in a mood for, little girl?
I tried to ask her a question, despite my unrest. Could you explain to me what's going on? Is what's written in that notebook the truth? It's up to you. Huh? It's up to you to decide whether what's written in there is real or fiction. Whether you believe is right becomes the truth. I want to believe that it isn't true, but unfortunately I have too many doubts to actually follow through with that. That means you believe it's real, so abide by that truth.
Yes, I'll play with you in a little bit.
Yeah, she is very vocal about being in a mood and wanting to play. Oh well.
Worthless, useless, pointless, meaningless. Shimon suddenly changed. There's no point to this anymore. Nothing will be born from this. It's worthless. She began to claw at her hair. She was so rough that I thought she was going to tear off her scalp. I'm leaving. Wait. Shut up. I don't even want to see you. Her angry shout made my body freeze. When a selfish host, things don't go your way, so you're leaving? The scenario has gone off track. Do you really think I'm obligated to give you information? Shimon began to fade into the darkness. Hang on. I tried to pursue her, but it's impossible, mate. Toe. Her utterance went from my right ear through to my left. I was in front of the table, sitting there cross-legged. Huh? Scene change. And I think at the point that I'm going to end this episode, a little bit longer than normal, but that's okay. At least for me. Kitten's even not happy about that, but, you know, she'll be fine. But, yeah, next time, we'll, hopefully be learning a little bit more about what's really going on. And, well, maybe learning a little bit more about as to why that shadow, why the shadow of Yuri, who is somebody that we know, well, maybe we'll figure out why she's here, but that might be for a little bit longer than next episode. Why she became conscious as well, like a certain other shadow that we've met in the past. But anyway, that is for next time, and I hope to see you all there.